I go boom.
All right, Glalie, thank you for your service. We will try and make it so that none of your friends join you. Raikou always faints to this because of the level 77 and the Slug Scarf. Max damage on the Suicune is about 98-99%. Thank you, Glalie. Let's go. One death Archie, and it was boom. Let's absolutely go. Uh-oh. Cutscene. Arr, I'm so angry. Arr, I'm also so angry. Ooh, this is like actually like the hypest cutscene in all. This is probably the most iconic cutscene in any Pokemon game, right? Except when Rayquaza comes down and beats them up. Inari, I think the 3 months. Wait, did he beat Watson? I lost Holter Sword Lantern, so I probably can't beat Watson anymore. Okay. I have to stare into Giratina. Ah, oh, there it is. Oh. I'm about to be a human sacrifice for Giratina. Alright, chat. Oh god. So we really want this to be below level 30. A high level here is atrocious for us. A low level is really good. It can be up to 66. 66 Duskull would be a nightmare for us. Slash potentially run ending. You want 33? Okay. Here we go. It's guaranteed Duskull, but what level is it? No teleport! No teleport! Okay, we are gonna double check this. Duskull, let's just double check this. We haven't caught it yet, so don't freak out yet. Level 34 is teleport. This is level 32. Pursuit, Confuse Ray, Shadow Sneak, and Foresight. So I have a guaranteed T-Wave here. I could Hypnosis it. Okay. Still switch to Wob. I have no reason to switch, right? It can't damage me outside of like, yeah. Is it evenly distributed, by the way? Does anyone know to be like lower level or higher level? Is it like just like, or is it like more likely to be higher or lower level? Uh-oh. Okay. Okay, evenly distributed. All right, we'll take it. We will super take it. We have to catch it though. I mean, like, it's definitely easier to catch this than if it were higher level. One, two, three. Let's go. Let's go. That's huge. Okay, yeah, chat, just catching the Duskull is good, but having a good IVs and nature on it is phenomenal. Like, would be really big. This is so cool. Perfectly balanced. Something came up. Me, when someone invites me to a party I don't want to go to. Sky Blast. I heard about Rayquaza. He uses Sword Dance. And then Bronzong gets faked out. We don't get Salamence. Or we don't get Rayquaza. Or Salamence. Bye-bye. The Sky Pillar. I wonder where it could be. Why don't you ask Wallace? He just came out. Wallace is like, I'm going to Sky Pillar. And Steven's like, he wants to seem cool. You know, he's like, oh yeah, like, yeah, yeah, I'll meet you there. And Steven's like, he's like on Google. You know, he's like, uh-oh. But you have the Dusclops. That's the most important thing. The real question is, what is the nature and what are the IVs and what is the ability? So why don't we pull that up now? Let's get started. Also, does it have, let's check the nature first. Level 32. Wait, isn't that really good? Isn't that like maybe best nature? Wait, hold on. I'm gonna level this thing up so I can get a better idea of the IVs. Stanley, you're so good. Wait, hang on. I think that's best nature in the game. Top three? Defenses might be better, but yeah, okay. HP is 30. HP is 30. Attack? Attack's not phenomenal. Attack's 19 or 18? No, it's exactly 19. HP is either, okay, it's exactly 30, exactly 19. Uh-oh. Attack exactly 2. Special attack doesn't really matter. Wait, it's not exactly 2, right? Special attack is like, oh. Uh-oh. It's 2 or 3. Okay. 2 or 3 defense. Uh-oh. 0 or 1 special defense. Fifteen speed. 30, 19, 2, 5, 0, 15. The thing is that Dusclops has worse HP than bulk. So it's actually like we value HP more than the bulk, right? I don't think it's bad. I think this could have been a lot worse in a lot of ways. I think plus attack Ivy is like really good. Okay, let's try it. This is very likely to be a duplicate. Unfortunate. Unfortunate. Oh well. I guess it's Kingdra in front of it because it walls most of the attacks. Okay, well, No, it's okay. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay. It's okay. It's fine, it's fine. I shouldn't have Giga Drained, but, like, I don't want to lose them on there. I'd much rather, like, yeah, no, it's fine. I'm fine with that. Alright, Gengar. Let's see it. That's okay, that's okay. That's solid, right? Solid Mon. Cool, alright, solid. Huh? Chat, that was really scary. Do I talk to it? Get him after League? Oh. Hello. Hey buddy, there's a bronze I'm gonna crowd on. I need you to click the button. Bye bye. I'm fighting. Level cap is 77. Wolf X, thank you for the prime. Here we go. Oh Lord. Sounds like Naruto music. Like Akatsuki music, you know what I'm saying? Uh-oh. Dude, if Kyogre just clicked Ice Beam, this Rayquaza would be donezo. Like, what's it gonna do? Dragon's Head isn't even in this game. Yeah, thank you, Guapo, I didn't know that. Alright, now I gotta go catch Kyogre and Groudon to win the game, and Rayquaza. Now that Nuzlocke is easy, haha. Oh, it didn't ambush me. Alright, Beauty Connie. Let's do this. Alright, chat. Let's give this a shot. Hello, Connie. Quillfish, this thing has Endure. However, its item is Lychee Berry. And I've traced Swift Swim, so I'm faster. If it was Salad Berry, I'd be kind of concerned, but it's not. It's Lychee Berry. I'm faster, it didn't use Endure. I get a free one shot. Megaworm can miss. 10% of the time it misses. Alright, we just don't want this to crit, ideally. Okay, I never did not. It always looks like it does more, but it only did 90 damage, which is what we expected. If this one does not. Okay, yeah, then we don't need to use. I want to use an experience sink, but it was safer to bring Kingdra as a backup for Sea King. Because, yeah. Trace has been consistently good. We were fine as long as one of them didn't crit. As long as this one didn't crit, basically. Yeah, we were fine. Having Weller with HP is nice as well. This should bring in Manectric, always clicks Thunder. Okay. KO with Earthquake. Bye-bye. Flygon has been good. Like, it hasn't been, like, it's not like meant where it can be used in, like, every match, but when Flygon is good, it's real good. Bye-bye. So now the only Pokemon that's threatening left is the Whiscash, who could, in theory, be a little bit annoying. I'm faster. This thing has Giga Drain, so if I did something wrong, then I would lose my Relicanth here to Giga Drain, but Ancient Power always kills. It's 4 times effective and gets crit for good measure. Okay, I could have pre-damaged to make sure this always attacked me, but I didn't think it was good. I don't know, maybe it was a mistake. I could, in theory, lose to Rock Slide Flinch, as I realize now. If it Dragon Dance is here, I should have pre-damaged. Okay. I just need to dodge Rock Slide Flinches. I think I made a mistake. I might if I flinch the first. So I'm not into Rock Slide crit now. I just forgot about flinches. I may have to sack Kingdra here if I flinch the first time and it does too much damage. Never I was only dead to, like, Rockslide Flinch there. Or, like, I was only in trouble to Rockslide Flinch. Like, the reason I didn't pre-damage Relicant is because it might have baited Muddy Water, which still wasn't good for me. And then Wobbly comes in. But it's not a fairy type, so I can just go into Flygon and kill it. Okay, this is where we're Lumberry. Mawile. Not today, Mawile. Okay. Exclamation point berries in the chat. Bye-bye. Alright, one down, seven to go. Ludicolo doesn't need to be seven. Ludicolo doesn't really matter here. Like, the thing is that Killua are the same. Okay, Party Time is the lead. The reason we're leading Party Time here is because it baits Brick Break and it can fake out turn one to get a little bit of chip damage you need on Crobat. Or for Crobat, I should say. Okay, it's Flinch. Now this should be Brick Break. Okay, I have a 4 times use this, so even though it's huge power, it doesn't do anything. Yep, 24 damage, not bad. Okay, and then I just Air Slash for the kill. Can never miss in this game. Skunger, man, thank you for the 16 months. I really appreciate that. Just do it. Just drum, dog. Give me the draw. Give me the drum. Nice. That's not going to help you. That's not going to help you, buddy. Because I trace Swift Swim, so Gardevoir now gets to go for it. Bop. All right, cool. All right, Intimidocti. It's good to have Arcanine. I like bringing Arcanine even in fights where it doesn't look immediately good because I can always late game extreme speed as a backup. All right, this is now, after this turn is the hard part of the fight. So even though we're in rain because of Caesar's 4 times weakness, this should still kill. Bye-bye. All right, now is the really spooky part, chat. So I left my Arcanine a little under level here to guarantee I bait Muddy Water here. I'm worried about accuracy drops. So that's really what can mess us up here. Like, I should have 2 shots at it at least, maybe. But I'm really worried about accuracy drops. So here's Muddy Water into my Sceptile. It has to use Muddy Water because it sees the kill with it. Okay, we just need it to not drop my accuracy. I think it's like a 70% chance to not drop accuracy. Does some damage. Okay, I'm just gonna double check my calc, but that should be a guaranteed kill now. Guaranteed one shot by it's overkill. Okay, and this is Azumarill from Battle Girl Chrissy, and its item is Lumberry, so it can't do anything about this. Cool. Step super lol. Yeah, that would be bad. This is Ice Beam or Dragon Dance. It's probably pretty likely to Dragon Dance here, right? Should I just attack again? Probably not, right? Am I dead to crit Ice Beam? I am dead to crit Ice Beam, but it's so likely to Dragon Dance here. Oh, also Leaf Blade is a 93. I'm gonna risk it. The odds of this not working are 1 in 16 times 1 in 16 times even less. I'm gonna go for the kill. It was a 93.8% chance to KO. I figure I may as well just take that. And Ice Beam didn't kill me. Only Ice Beam crit, and it was more likely to Dragon Dance there anyway. All right, Electabuzz. This isn't ideal though, right? Because now Electabuzz is using Ice Punch. I could have pivoted Arcanine. That would have been good as well. Yeah, maybe pivot Arcanine is better there. That's true. I kind of wanted a little fake out chip damage here, though. Because now, after one more fake out, I think Surf kills, but I'd have to double check, but it shouldn't matter here. This is always Thunder. Uh-oh. Don't understand why that happened. It's a high crit move. High crit moves, it can always click. It can always click high crit moves. Okay. Right, I forgot that that was a fun little feature in this game. So it's going to Ice Punch here. I'm dead to Ice Punch crit. Do I have any counterplay to this? As long as I don't get crit on this Ice Punch, it's fine. Okay, just don't crit me on this Ice Punch. I have Lumberry. Oh, I gave it Citrus Berry, right? So it could get frozen. Nice static, by the way. It's just Lumberry, but it's mental damage. Okay, Thunder Crit maximum damage is 168. I have 100. Okay. That was max roll Ice Punch, so I'm never dead to Thunder Crit. That could be bad. That's bad. Okay, well. Let's see here. I'm now dead to Thunder Crit, and it can just cross chop me again, because it just randomly cross chop. But I think it doesn't like to do it into actually, no, I don't actually know how it works. I definitely pivot back into this to try and reset the situation. That's a pretty bad Thunder para though. Okay. I mean, I can just risk crit on Golem here if I want, right? So I'm gonna go back into Gardevoir on this. The reason is that it never thunders me, and if I'm baiting, I can, like, as long as I feel above 70 health, I'm never dead to anything. And I'm tracing static every time, so I can actually try this one more time. Because if it paras here, it makes my life a lot easier. Okay, I didn't para, but I can do that one more time. Okay, I'm never in crit ice punch range, right? Max damage critical hit ice punch is 35%, which is 70 HP. So I can do this one more time. The issue is, could I be baiting a different move after that? I could be baiting ice punch after that. No, I'm not baiting ice punch or, this always works. Okay, one more chance at static here. I'm trying to need a para. I'm doing this until I risk Guardy. Give me the static. Unfortunate. Okay. I'm now in range of Thunder. Ice Punch shouldn't kill me from here. Let me just double check that on my Golem. Ice Punch needs a crit to kill my Golem, I believe. At 77. So I'm risking... I'm basically playing... Yeah, max damage is 110. I guess I'm just risking Ice Punch crit here, right? I don't have another play except to switch back into Arcanine, but it doesn't get me anywhere, right? Yeah, I have to risk Ice Punch crit here. Okay. This is a really unfortunate cross chop. Come on, Golem. You're so good. Golem, I love you so much. Alright. Ice Punch makes contact move. I'd already parried once. Alright, good job, Golem. You have been really good, I'm not gonna lie to you. Yeah, I need to recover a couple times, actually. Alright, chat, this could be the end of the run. Let's give it a shot. Come on, Milotic, don't let me down now. Draco Meteor is a third, right? Okay. Third of recoil. I mean, I'm so nervous. All right, 285 minus, this should do about 33% of my health. 180. 75 HP. Okay, the first one did 75 HP. Yeah, okay, 75, so it did 75 divided by 3. So this Kingdra is currently at 223 minus 25. It's currently at 198 HP. I need to recover again. Don't crit me. This time it did 74, that's another low roll. Okay. This time it took 24 damage. So it had 198 minus 24. It's now at 174 HP. I have to recover again. Okay, that was a high roll. It takes 27 from that. 27, 174 minus 27. Let's see, 174 minus 27. It's now 147 HP. I can now Mirror Coat. Don't crit me on this one. Please, just want this one. Just don't crit on this one. Come on. You've got... Okay. Alright, that's fine. If I had done that earlier, I would have just recovered it off, but now I can't do that. Okay, bad start. Like, it was fine to get crit, it just wasn't fine to get crit on that turn. Come on. Thunder? Okay. There's nothing that should be able to go wrong here, I think. Crits don't matter, para doesn't matter. They crit me. Okay. That's why I EV'd specifically for that. Okay. Sceptile, you've been with us since the very beginning. I'm sorry. I really am sorry. I would have liked if we could have done something differently here. I really would have. But there's no way for you to save yourself because you can't crit because of the shell armor, so... Goodbye, Sceptile. Thank you for everything you've done for us. We'll try and bring it home for you. So close. That was a high roll, too. Goodbye, Sceptile. Thank you for what you've done. And hopefully, in a perfect world, none of your friends are joining you here. All right, we're gonna play, let's chat. It's time to do the very scary part of this fight. The very, 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 very scary part of this fight. It's always kills with gunk shots. So now is where things get really spooky, chat. Now is where things get really, really spooky on this stupid Swampert. This is the part that I've been the most worried about. First of all, we needed to not max roll Earthquake here. It's always Earthquaking. Always. Do not max roll me. That's not a max roll, okay. All right, it has to either Earthquake or Yawn, chat. Yawn me. Okay, that's really good. I think Slowbro lives now. Slowbro should live now. Okay, wow. Okay, that's really good. I thought that was most likely because it didn't see a kill, but what if it yawns again? Ah, so let's talk about this, chat. What if it yawns again, right? It can yawn here and my Slowbro would fall asleep. However, we needed to get a little bit of chip damage on this thing, right? In order to ensure that it was never, that it was always hit to Magical Leaf. And so, by switching in Ludicolo now, I'm guaranteeing either coming in an Earthquake or a Yawn, and either option is fine. The one thing we were worried about here is Ancient Power boost, because if an Ancient Power boosted and things went badly, then we would have probably wiped. So we were manipulating it so that the odds of an Ancient Power boosting were really, really low. We're now faster, and because of the chip damage, we always kill. Okay. Perfect. Oh, that's super perfect. Okay, I'm faster in Gunk Shot. So I'm moving to the first slot. Always kills. Okay, Quillfish being out here is good. And the reason it's good is because Surf never kills me. So I get a... Oh, Gunk Shot is a two shot. And Surf crit never kills me. Well. Why are its odds of critting so much higher than its odds of getting hitting a Hypnosis? Okay. I would have used Toxic if it wasn't Lumberry. Okay, no crit. Doesn't matter, I would have lived anyway. First gym leader down. Sceptile, I'm sorry, but it was the only way. I couldn't find another way to do it. Not without risking the entire run. No overleveled. All right. Sceptile, thank you very much for your service. I'm out of here. Peace, homie. I am one trainer away from having 8 badges. 8 badges and done with the gym part of the game. Sceptile, thank you. Really thank you. You were phenomenal. You were exactly what we needed. You were with us for so long. You were so good. And I have some good news. You're gonna have some new friends very soon. It's been a long run, chat. It's been about 2 months. This is our final badge. We've suffered to get here. We've had some major setbacks. We've been discouraged. We've been downtrodden. We've been ready to give up. There have been many moments of this run that tried to break us. And I'm not gonna lie, some of them came pretty close. And yet here we are in front of a cracked sheet of ice, staring down the man with impeccable style. And soon the man to have 0 Pokemon out of his initial 6. This is the final gym leader and the final badge of the run. After this, we have to get through Victory Road and then the Elite Four. We've had sacrifices. We've had setbacks. We've lost a lot of our good friends. We've sacrificed a lot of Pokemon to get here, and we're gonna sacrifice probably 2 more. But I wouldn't have had it any other way. You know, every Pokemon, every part of this journey, every setback, it brought us here, standing in front of Juan.
All right, Cloyster, your first and last fight. We caught you, we were really happy, and I'm, you know, Cloyster, I'm sure it's not what you wanted, but it's what we needed. And I want you to know I appreciate that. Me monkey, use Endure Blast. Octazooka, uh-oh, I got Octazooked, guys, that's kind of bad. I go down to my Endure HP. Now, Cloyster is actually faster, which is super nice. And because I used Explosion, it kills both.
All right, that's Kingdra down and Lapras down. Oh, just kidding. I have Endure.
Cloyster, thank you. You'll have another friend soon, and hopefully that's it. Two down. Four to go. Now, both these Pokemon are pretty strong. We don't want to get damage on our Dusclops. So, we're going to boom. Just lagging there for a second, kind of freaked me out. And switch into Dusclops. So Dusclops is immune, and because of Swift Swim, we're faster than both these Pokemon. So even though they're both targeting down, my Primate slot here, it's fine. Cast form, goodbye. Quillfish. You know, I really expected you to be phenomenal, I'm not gonna lie. And for the most part, I feel like we could have done without you, but not here. Here is where we really needed you, and here is really where you really came through. Thank you for your service. Hopefully there will be no more friends joining you. All right, they're final, his final two Pokemon. I'm going to use Endure one more time. Well, maybe one more time after that. And Shadow Ball into the Ludicolo. Because my Dusclops is adamant, this has a chance to two-shot. This, they're both forced to target down Primate. We're Lumberry to try and prevent the alt of status like that. Okay. It's fine. Not great, but fine. I would like to not end this turn with a freeze, ideally. It's unlikely to go for Ice Punch or T-Punch here. Yep, Chicka Drain. Alright. Alright, chat. Now, what would be really nice here, what would be super nice, is if this crits. Okay, no worries. All right, here's the scary turn. Because I don't know, like, their moves are both random. So ideally, it's the water move to Kingdra. Technically, it's better to go Ludicolo here. However, I'm very spooked about a crit. Crit Hydro Pump could, or crit double crit could kill my Ludicolo. So we're going to our worst mon here, Ice Beam. Just don't crit me and we should survive. Oh, Giga Drain would be kind of bad. Oh, I got the perfect move twice in a row. That's unfortunate. Okay. Should heal a lot there. Dusclops, any critters? Any crits? It's okay. Okay, all right. Now I'm where I'm a little bit spooked. Okay, Kingdra definitely has to KO the Ludicolo here. And I believe Dragon Breath should do it, even though I'm very weak. We may lose Kingdra this turn if we're unlucky. Dragon Breath is a guaranteed kill here, so I'm going for Dragon Breath into the Ludicolo, and I'm actually going to switch into my own Ludicolo, because if I lose Dusclops to crit, then I'm in huge trouble. I think this is okay as long as I dodge one crit here. Shadow Sneak? If it crit Hydro Pumps me, guys, what happens if it crit Hydro Pumps me? Then I lose Dusclops. Don't tell me to Shadow Sneak! Okay, hopefully I leveled Kingdra up quickly. I didn't level up correctly. See? It Hydro Pumped. If that had crit, it would have been the end of the run. Okay, this fight is not over yet. How do I get out of this? Okay. Then I'm going to Endure, baiting the attack from Vaporeon, and I'm going to Magical Leaf. Oh, it's faster than me. Oh god. Crits me, that's fine. Okay. So the question now becomes, first of all, does this crit? Because that'd be kind of lit. Okay, it doesn't crit. All right, the question is, is it gonna crit my Kingdra for the kill? I go back into Kingdra here. And I Magical Leaf one more time. Yeah, Ludicolo is not very strong, unfortunately. Kingdra, save your own life. Oh, Hidden Power? That's not gonna kill me with crit. Okay. Okay, chat, moment of truth. This Vaporeon's taken Fake Out, Magical Leaf, Magical Leaf. Oh, wait, Kingdra's in range. Kingdra's in range. So either Double Edge might kill from here, or I can just dive, right? Vaporeon's about 20%. Double Edge should kill here. However, dive is safer. Bye-bye! Vaporeon is supposed to swim. It does not have surf. I checked, though. Thank you for asking. That's it. That's every badge. We have 8 badges. Oh, that's kind of crazy. Let's go. Let's actually go. Oh, 8 badges. 8 badges, Emerald Kaizo. I'm really proud of that. That's kind of incredible. Thank you for all the gift subs, everybody. I really appreciate that. Oh, water pulse. Thank you. Oh man, that was so scary. Yeah, I could have gone into Ludicolo and just had an easier win, but I was scared of I was too scared of losing Ludicolo on a crit. Because a single it was possible to lose Ludicolo there if I messed up. I'm really proud of that, chat. I think that we've really kind of we've come a long way even from the beginning of this run. So now the final level cap is level 100. Level 100. So okay, we lost a couple mods today. I think it was necessary. I think it wasn't a pleasant sacrifice, but it was necessary, and it made the fight a lot easier. Primeape has also been a super carry this run, by the way.